Hey guys, it's Ted with OAXRAY, and today I'm very excited to let you guys know about our new supported site, toysrus.co.uk, which is our first international, actually UK website that we support. First thing you're going to need to do is go to the options by right-clicking the OAXRAY extension. Go to options, you're going to come up to a page like this. Make sure your marketplace is on the UK if you want to compare this to US to UK marketplace. You can also compare toysrus.uk to the US or Canada, and this is going to give you information if you want to purchase it in the UK and sell it in the United States. So this opens up a whole lot of opportunities in just different countries. Whenever you're done doing this, you just hit save and everything will be on par to the amazon.uk system. So on the toysrus.co.uk site, we see that there's a free $10 gift coupon when you spend $40 or more. So just click on that link and scroll down. The easiest way to go through a section is to just go see all, because it's going to reduce the amount of pages that populate. I'm always going to put the results as high as I can, and here we go, 96 per page, just so it's less clicking around. And I'm going to click on the OAXRAY extension a couple times, maybe three pages, to see if we come up with anything that looks like a good buy. Now, I have been looking into a source to purchase gift cards from, and I found a source that is 8% off. Now, just a note as we're going along here, you can see at the top, the little checkbox is going to tell me when an OAXRAY is completed running. So I clicked on the OAXRAY extension on page 1. There were 96 and it's complete. Page 2, page 3, page 4. And right now I'm on page 5. That's the last one I'll run. And I go here. Now I'm looking at a discount of 8%. And I found that percentage. Let's see, 8%. And we'll just see if we come up with anything positive. Now, to see the My Buys, which I don't think anything here is going to make the criteria, I click here on My Buys, and that's going to sort everything by the rank and ROI thresholds. What I'm just going to do is look for the first positive ROI thing I see, just so we can kind of go over the process. This is not meant to show you BOLOs or anything like that. Here we can see Keep a Graph goes back to January 2016, so we have about 3 months of data on this item. And I'm going to click there. And it looks like the items match, but let's just go into a little bit more detail here. Okay, so we have a Ghostbusters 508 piece. Looks like it's selling for $50, $57.09. Now, on the UK market, we're using British pounds to calculate all of these things. So remember, if you're purchasing something in the UK and you want to sell it in the United States, you have to do those conversions of currency so that you can make sure that items are actually profitable. So here we go. We see that you can pick it up. It's in store for $44.99. The items look like they match. We can look at the same picture here, and it looks like it's just a standard stock photo. If you live close to one, you can just click it and collect it from the store, or you can ship the item to your house. And the cool thing about this item was, not only are you going to, if let's pretend you wanted to buy this item, we're going to get a $10 voucher back on this item. So really, you're paying $34.99, plus you're going to go to a website to get discounted gift cards. This is just one that I found by a simple Google search, so I'm not sure their policy and all those types of things, but you're going to want to look to see if you can find a good source for discounted cards. And 8% is what we get in the United States generally, so that seems to be on par with that. So find yourself some discounted gift cards, and if you have a equivalent to Ebates in the UK, use that also, because I don't believe Ebates works in the UK. So here we are back on the listing page. We see that this has 105 reviews. So just on that piece of information, and the fact is, whoa, that's amazing. Rarely do you see not a single negative review. These are all 5-star. The worst is one person giving it a 3-star. So one thing that I like about positive reviews is you're not so worried about returns and people being unhappy with it, because generally When you have a lot of positive reviews, that means people are happy when they get it. Just looking at the sales rank is only 2,426 here. And it's just a good sale. It looks like a good sales rank overall. I am not a sales rank in the United States does not necessarily translate directly into a sales rank in the UK. The market is smaller than in the United States. So as you begin to enter the UK market, make sure that you understand the differences in the sell-through rates and the differences in the sales rank in each category compared to the United States if you're a US seller. Now I'm going to look at the item weight, 621 grams. I think that's about a little bit over a pound. Product dimensions, 34, 19, 5. That's in centimeters. So I believe that's going to be about 13 by 8 by probably about 3 inches. It's not a very big item, so it's going to be an easy item to ship. Next thing we're going to do is just pull up the FBA calculator so we can get some other basic use information. So right here, I've pulled up the FBA calculator. I have a little widget right here or a little extension right here. You just click it and it pulls it up and it automatically puts a price in of the lowest seller. So here we can see with this item, we're going to make $46.72. That's not including any prep center fees if we have to bag it and ship it inbound. So if you live in the UK and you're able to ship this item for 50 cents, we can plug in 50 cents here in the prep service field or more if we want to account for boxes and such. In a prep service field, I like to put the cost that I'm going to buy the item at. Since I'm going to stack my $10 voucher, that puts us at $34.99, and then I'm going to get 8% back approximately. We're just going to call it $33. We're going to end up paying for the item. So whenever we recalculate this, it's going to be about a $13 return on a $33 investment. Again, everyone has their own rules for how much they are willing to spend and how much they are willing to make back. So that's going to be your decision. Now, one thing to remember is that if we are not counting that voucher, then we're at $44.99 and the profit is essentially zero. So using all of the things that you can, so by stacking the $10 cash back, by stacking any, if there's a sale, 20% off or anything like that, is going to be really important to keeping your margins large enough to make a profit. So make sure if you see any of the percentage offs in the page, especially if you have to input a code, that you take the time to do these kinds of tasks. One quick thing I want to show you is here we have a per unit fee, which I put in as $1. And that's how we got our net payout. I could put a negative $10 here. And that's actually, sorry, did that 100. And what it's going to essentially do is add $10 to the net profit. So if I had a sale where I knew every time I bought an item, I got $10 back or something like that, I can add a negative number here in the per unit fee, and it will do all the calculations based on adding that to the cost of the item. Or if I want to, let's see. If I want to account for the VAT tax, or I want to account for any kind of other taxes that may be included, I could add that here as a negative number. So I could add here 20% or 200% or whatever I wanted to add. And that would account for the additional cost of the percentage of the VAT tax or whatever percentage there is. In the UK, I know they have the VAT tax, but I would recommend that everybody look up this information so that they know what their margins are actually going to be after any taxes, shipping costs, or anything like that. Thank you very much for listening to me today. Thank you very much. Have a nice day and make some money using OAXRAY.